to look at little ones, isn't it? You know, this time of the year, we think about the birth of Jesus and what actually took place. I mean, it was an absolute miracle. First of all, it was predicted over 500 years in advance. Daniel 9 predicted when Christ would come, when he would be born in 27 AD. We find that the star led the wise men from the east, probably in the realm of Persia somewhere. They had been studying the writings of Balaam. They had been studying the writings of Daniel, probably. And also, they liked to study the stars, and the strange star was leading them, led them to Jerusalem, where God's people were, the people who had the book. And they should have known. In fact, they did know all about the birth of Jesus, but they didn't want to admit that anyone but them could be given any light at all. But Herod got it out of them, and Herod told the wise men, "Hey, go worship this young child. And when you come back here, let me know where he's at so I can come and worship him too. Worship him my foot." We know exactly what he was going to do, right? He was going to try to do Jesus in. But the wise men, we don't know for sure how many wise men there were. There were three gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh, a gift for a prophet, priest, and a king. However, we don't know for sure. It doesn't say how many wise men. Must have been more than one. But they came and worshiped Jesus and gave them a precious gift. And so tonight we're going to try to celebrate when Jesus came and to this earth to save man from his sins. And let's have prayer before we start this evening. Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you so much for all that you do. Thank you for coming to this world and becoming like one of us to save us from our sins. Bless our gathering tonight, for it is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can I come and meet the newborn Christ child?
How are you? Oh, isn't he cute? Look at those blue eyes. Yeah. How are you?
Would everybody like to turn to their hymnals, number 142? And you can rise if you're able. 142. Angels We Have Heard on High. next up, Katie, Chloe.
Connected.
I think it's connected.
Now it's connected.
Okay. Do you have the video?
Yes. Okay.
Chosen me.
breath of heaven.
Okay, next up, he's not written on here, but I do believe that Fred had something that he'd like to share. Is that correct, Fred?
Page is it? 141. We're going to do 141. You're welcome to join in.
Next up, we have Justin singing Strange Way to Save the World.
Strange way to save the world. This microphone is way too low. Maybe a little of both, but I'm trying to record this. All right. Well, I gave these sheet music to Adam a little too late, and there's like 8 pages of it. So this is going to be a cappella. I'm sure he must have been surprised at where this road had taken him. 'Cause never in a million lives would he have dreamed of Bethlehem. And standing at the manger, he saw with his own eyes the message from the angel come to life. And Joseph said, why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him? With all the rulers in the world, why here? Inside this stable filled with hay, why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world. To think of how it could have been if Jesus had come as he deserved. There would have been no Bethlehem, no lowly shepherds at his birth. But Joseph knew the reason love had to reach so far. And as he held the Savior in his arms, he must have thought, why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him? With all the rulers in the world, why here? Inside this stable filled with hay, why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world. Such a strange way. This is such a strange way. A strange way to save the world.
Zach come up for a reading of Luke.
Well, I don't really read too clearly, so it's also in your little pamphlet thingy in the back. So if you want to follow along, be better for you. So I'll start off. This isn't New King James, by the way. Christ born of Mary, second, and it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. To this census, it first took place while, I don't know how to pronounce his name, but it starts with a Q, was governing Syria. Also went to registered everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and the lineage of David, to be registered with Mary. He betrothed his wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him swaddling in his swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For this is there is to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord, and this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly they were with the angel, a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger. Now when they had seen him, they made it widely known, the saying which was told to them concerning the child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things were told by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising the Lord of all the things that kept heard and seen as it was told to them. Yeah. I hope you understood that.
Song on 118, the first Noel.
Born is the King.
Next up, we have Mr. Joe Carney that has a song and a little bit of a story for us.
Okay, now the story, pretty much all my previous entertainers here pretty much give the story away. So I'm just going to go off with the song here. So basically it's about Mary's baby boy, and that's what it's about, because Pastor, he told about our Savior. Zach did his reading for his, Justin did his song. So that about covered everything I had to say in my story. So I'm just going to go ahead with my song here. So, and this will be a cappella because I can't follow music like everybody else does. So I just do the best I can. So here we go. A long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible said, Mary's, can you turn the floodlights on? I cannot see. Because this is black print. There's no way I can see this. There we go. Here we go. A long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible say, Mary's child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day. Hark now, hear the angels sing, new king born today. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. Trumpets sound, the angels sing. Listen to what they say. That man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. While shepherds watch their flocks by night, they see a bright new star. Then hear a choir of angels sing, music seems to come from afar. Now Joseph and his wife Mary come from Bethlehem that night. They find no place to lay their child, not a single room inside. Hark now, hear the angels sing, new king born today. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. Trumpets sound, the angels sing. Listen to what they say. The man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. By and by they find a little nook in a stable so forlorn. In a manger cold and dark, Mary's little baby boy was born. Hark now, hear the angels sing, new king born today. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. Thank you.
Next up is a song together. It's hymn number 125, 125. And that's Joy to the World.
Earth receive.
Next up, gentlemen of all ages and talents and joyful noise, you can come up here to sing Go Tell It on the Mountain, which is 121. Go Tell It on the Mountain. So, gentlemen, I expect to see you. I see Pastor, I see Fred, I see Zach, Caleb. Joe didn't go far.
Those that come up here first get to stand farthest from the mic. Yeah, I can hold the book.
All right, we'll let you.
That's one thing I can do. Oh, yeah.
We want a book or we want this?
You tell me where to go.
I think they're the same.
I don't sing and now I got the microphone.
Fight one of them boys on the end.
Ladies, it's our turn for women's choir. We're going to sing Silent Night, Holy Night, which is 143. So ladies of all ages and abilities, come on up. Come on, Lucy. We need little girls. You don't have to, you can just stand there and look cute.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child. Holy infant so tender,
this time we have Pastor Lincoln with a closing prayer for us. I just want to thank everybody who showed up tonight and participated, and Adam and Norma who's helped play a piano, and everybody that helped decorate. So just thanks so much, guys.
And our beautiful nativity, too. Keeping kids quiet that long is not an easy task.
Yes, and thank you, Stacy, and all of those who helped to put all this together. It was good for all of us to come out here again this evening and have fun. We do this every year. It's kind of an annual thing. And thank you for the wonderful family up here that gave us joy and had us take a look at what the Christ child must have kind of looked like about 2,000 years ago. Thank you for being here. Well, let's have closing prayer before we dismiss, shall we? Heavenly Father, we just want to take a moment to thank you for the birth of Jesus and that he was willing to come to this world and save us from our sins and die for our sins and give us the grace and the example that we need to live the Christian life. Please guide now and direct us. And I pray that you will keep us safe and at last save a place for us in your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen.